The pool. Now can you see Rohit? The pool. Actually, pole should come without the screen. Okay, we will mute everyone. Yes. Okay. Anyone who wants to unmute? Okay, you. Okay, Rohit, you can see the Excel sheet. Okay, I think probably, when did you download this software? When did you download this software? Okay, I get yesterday. Okay. Let's see, I have to see this, but okay, anyway, the polling, I see 100% result. Okay, so can you see this sharing of the poll, or you still see Excel? Rohit, what do you see? Are you still see Excel or the poll result? Okay, actually I think some issue is probably there. You should see the poll result. Okay, now what do you see? Now can you see the result? Okay, so let's see. I think probably we'll after this class I will try to diagnose your issue. Okay, as of now, so all of you, like, more, the middle is average. So let's see. So 36% are in 3. So we can see that 40% are 4 or 5, very comfortable, and 60% are in this range. So it's good. I have to, let's see, start. Okay. So in case of Excel, okay, probably that is what I put it in the poll. You would have seen some formula like this. Okay, dollar E, dollar 2, or you would have seen a formula like this, dollar E2, E dollar 2. Or E2. Okay. Now, the best thing about the Excel is, okay, in fact, you will see that 16% of the world's population use Excel as a software. Okay. The best, why they use Excel? Because it can solve a lot of your problems. Okay. And large data set problems, it can easily solve. Okay. Now, how Excel can solve these large problems is because the way it manages the formula. Okay. So you have how it can handle this, because the way it structures the formula. Okay, so whenever we write E dollar, dollar E2 or E dollar 2 or dollar E2, it means that it is referring to a cell. Okay, so you can see that a grid is there, and this grid is how you have a column names are here. These are columns, and this is column A, column B, column C, and these are the rows that you have. So when we are saying dollar E dollar 2, it means column E and the second row. So it is referring to this particular cell. Dollar E2 is also referring to this cell. This is also referring. So all of these formulas are referring to this cell. Okay. But the difference is coming. Okay. The difference is coming on when you drag the formula to the other cells. So we'll bring slowly. Now, how do you write a formula? So whenever you have to write a formula, you have to start with equal to. So equal to, you have to start, okay, and then you write a formula. I would not recommend you to type the values. So I will never recommend you to type the values. Okay, so see, when I've typed E2, you can see this blue shade has come. It means that you are referring to this cell. Okay. But instead of that, you type equal to and hover the mouse on the cell and do left click. So when you do left click, you can see that it is highlighted. Okay. So let's say if you want to multiply this with this, So you move with your mouse rather than typing the cell values. Why it is important? Okay, because we have seen that when you type the cells, okay, numbers, cell column name and the rows number, you make a lot of error. Okay, people make error. So you should always drag, you should always refer the cells like this. You can enter into, but you can do like this. That is the way it should be done. Okay. Now, this is a simple question that I have. So the question is that, let's say tax rate is 10%. Okay. So it is, this is a country, there is a flat tax rate for all the citizen, whoever, if even is a billionaire or is earning, let's say 1,000 rupees, he has to pay 10% tax. We have to compute in this cell how much is the tax he will pay. So the income is 8 lakh. The tax rate is 10%. So it's no brainer that the tax will be income multiplied by the tax rate, because it's a flat tax country, tax rate country. So what you are going to do is, you are going to write a formula equal to, select this one, into 10%. This is how you will write. And you press enter. So the tax has come. 8 lakh into 10%. Now, if you want to compute the tax for the another person, should you do like this, equal to this into this cell, D7 into E2. So if you are doing this, let's say again, you are coming to the third person, you will do this into this. Imagine you have, let's say, 5 lakh income, 5 lakh people's income. You have to do the formula 5 lakh times. Okay. It is not advisable. So what Excel has done is, Excel has a way to write formula in all the other cells. Even though you are writing formula once, it will get populated in all other cells. So once you have written the formula and press enter, okay, if you bring your mouse and click left click on the E6, you can see that, we can zoom it. Okay, you can see that there's a slight over here. Okay, so that means Excel is giving you a way to drag. So you bring the mouse and you bring to the down corner, down right corner. You can see one plus icon will come. Normally the thick plus icon comes, but when you bring this to here, that place, the plus icon becomes a thinner one. So this is called as a drag tool. So with this, you can drag the formula to other cells. So if I bring this here and I drag the formula, so dragging is by pressing the left button of the mouse and dragging it down. So I can drag it. I can drag it till here also. Okay. Now this is the way Excel formula works. You write a formula in one cell and drag it to all other place. Okay. Don't worry about what it is giving me now. It is giving me all some garbage values. It is giving me. What is the reason? The reason is that this Excel formula is not constructed smartly. Okay. So for that, we have to understand what happens when we drag the formula. So when I have this formula, see what is the values written. The formula has D6 cell and E2 cell. Okay. Now when we are dragging down, okay. Now when we are dragging down, is the formula column change, is the column changes for this cell? No, the column remains the same. But what happens to the row? So this cell is 6th row. This cell is 7th row. So when you drag down, the row changes, okay, and it changes by 1, 1, 1. Each of the rows is changing by 1. Okay. So for with that, let's see the formula that is here. Okay. So what was the formula here? It is D6 into E2. And what the formula here? D7 into E3. See this. This was D6. This is D6. This is D7. This is E2. This cell is E2. Or let's say we write here. Okay. This cell is E2. This cell is E3. Okay. When you have come here, you are referring to this cell D7, which is correct because the income is 7 lakh. But instead of referring to E2 cell, you are referring to E3 cell. Why it has happened? Because you have increased the row number by 1 when you have dragged down. Okay. So all the formulas cell, it will increase, the row will increase by 1. So D6 will become D7, E2 will become E3. We are not changing the column. So only rows are changing. So the row sequence will change. So 7 and 3 has come. But do you want this to be 3? Or do you want it to remain at E2? You want it to remain at E2 because the tax rate is not changing. So what can be done? So there comes the referencing. Okay, understanding the referencing or fixing of the referencing. We want to fix the cell E2 here only. We don't want to move it. Okay, so I call that as anchoring. So we can say that when you anchor a ship, what will happen? The ship will stay in the place, right? So we have to do this anchoring. And anchoring is done by this dollar sign. Dollar symbol does the anchoring. So you can anchor row or you can anchor column. Or you can anchor row, both row and column. Currently, you have to tell me whether you are anchoring, you have to anchor row or column. So see, you are going down. Column is changing. No, column is not changing. But the row has changed. But I don't want the row to change. I want it to remain at E2. So what you should do? So you should say that the two has to be anchored or fixed by putting a dollar sign. So how do you anchor a reference? By putting a dollar sign. So dollar sign is anchoring. So if you put $2, means that 2 is fixed. It cannot change. It will not become 3 when you drag it down. So let's see how do we anchor. As I said that you can put dollar sign before this. Okay. But I don't recommend manually entering the dollar sign. You have a shortcut. F4 is the button. F4 is a toggle button. See, if I press F4, it becomes all anchor. Column and both row have become anchored. But I don't want this. I want this. So I will stop at this. So if I keep on pressing, I am pressing F4 again and again. So it will move. It will change. I have now moved it to E$2. Okay. And I press enter. Okay. Now what I will do is I will drag this formula down. Okay, let's delete this. Okay. So here it was referring to this cell correctly. Here it is referring to this cell, same cell. And the formula has not changed. It from E2, it has not become E3 because of this anchoring. Okay. That is what you are putting. Okay. So my intention is to not change this 10%, but my intention is definitely to change this. From 88 lakh, I want to get the 7 lakh. So it has changed. So this formula D7. So D7 is an example of relative referencing. Okay. Means it is relative. If you increase the row by 1, it will become 8. If you increase the column, it will become E, like that. D or E$2 is an example of mixed referencing. Okay. Here you have fixed only row. Okay. So you have fixed only row. Now here we could have actually fixed both row and column also. See, I could have fixed both row and column, and many people do this and it still will work. This, why it has worked? Because when we are dragging, okay, we are not changing the column. So when it is this E$2, also it is the same value we are getting. Or when it is $E$2, then also we are getting the same value. See, I can put it here, this formula, and put F4 $E$2, and I am getting the same values. Because it doesn't matter when you are in the column, when you are dragging the values, the column is not going to change. So E$2 remains the same. So these two will give the same result. However, I recommend you think. Okay. So here I would recommend this is a better formula than this. There was no use of full referencing here. So you have full referencing or absolute referencing. So what is the example of absolute referencing? Both row and column are fixed. So the row is fixed, column is fixed. That is absolute referencing. Okay. So mixed referencing, I gave an example of fixing only row, but there can be another example of fixing only column that we will see later. Okay. So fix only column. So relative referencing has no fixing or no anchoring. Mixed referencing has fixing either row or column. Absolute referencing has fixing both row and column. Okay. Let me bring another problem to you. Let's say this is a problem. It is extension of the previous problem. Okay. It is an extension of the previous problem. Here you have tax rate. Now, instead of one country, we are talking about three countries. One country has 10% tax, 8% tax, another country, third country has 5% tax. And we want to know, let's say you are evaluating whether you should be a citizen of country 1, 2 or 3. You want to know how much is the tax outflow you have. Okay. So if you are earning 8 lakh in country 1, what is your tax? 8 lakh in country 2, what is your tax? And 8 lakh in country 3, what is your tax? You want to evaluate. And you want to write a formula here. And you want to drag that formula to the down and also to the right such that you get the correct value. So you are not going to enter formula in every cell. You have to write one formula here, drag it, and it should get completely filled. So you have to think of that formula. So first what we'll do is we'll write a knife formula. We know that, okay, it has to be tax, has to be rate, has to be multiplied with income. Okay. And we write it. So for first row, it has come correctly. Now, if I drag this down, will it work? No, it suffers from the issue which we have resolved just now. So we'll say that I will fix the row here and I will drag it down. So I have fixed the row and I have dragged it down. Okay, it is coming correctly. Right? But note that I had said that I have to write one formula here and also I should be able to drag it to the right. And still I get the same answer. Should get. But see, when I'm dragging this to the right. So before showing the formula, you have to think what will happen here. So you have to tell me when we are dragging this to the right, is row changing? No, row is not changing. Is column changing? Yes, you are shifting from column D to column E. So I want to know what change will happen in the formula. So this is column number C. You are going from here to here. So C will change to D. So in this, the formula will come D6. Why D6? Because row has not changed. Multiplied by D$2 will become what? It one row, one column has increased. So it will become E$2. Okay. Now when you have to compute a tax in this, what should be the tax? Tax will be calculated on this multiplied by 8%, which is E2. So you can see that this E2 is correct. But what about this D6? Is this correct? D6 refers to this cell, not this cell, which was my requirement. So this formula is wrong. So let's see. We drag it to the right, okay, and see what happens. When we are here, you can see that the column has from C6, it has become D6, which is wrong. This is not the requirement. What to be done then? What to be done? Anybody on the chat, what should we do? So column has changed. D6 it has become, it should have been C6. When we are dragging to the right, it should have been C6, but it has become D6. What can be done? So we have to fix the column. Okay. So we have to fix this. C, we have to make it fix. So we have to make it dollar C. So when we are going across, it will not change. So we can do this here. We can bring this dollar C6. So now when I drag it, see, this is 8 lakh multiplied with 8%. This is 8 lakh multiplied with 5%. So this is coming perfectly fine. And when we are dragging this down, this is also coming perfectly fine. So actually you can take this formula, drag it to the left and to the right and down. This is the formula you should write. How you will check? You can go to any cell and you see that C9 is in blue. It is referring to this. E2 is in green. It is referring to this. Okay, so you can see that this formula is correct. So before completing the work, you should check by going to other cells whether the formula is as expected or not. Okay. Another way you can do is when you have a complex file, okay, you can go to formulas and you have this button over here, trace precedence. Okay. So this will check what are the precedence of this cell. So if I click this, I can see that, okay, F2 and C2 are the precedence of this. That is what I can get. So this is for simple exercise. It is not a big thing, but if you are working on a big complex formula, okay, it will work perfectly. Okay. Now I have a good question from one of the students. Let's see. So this is the, whether if I write this formula, will it be okay or not? So I've put in the chat $C$2 × $D$2. So what we'll do is we'll type this formula and see. Okay. So we'll, by the way, this dependency is good when you have complex sheets. You can remove the arrows now. So you can remove the arrows. You have trace precedence and trace dependence. So this 10% where it is all used, you can click on dependence. See, 10% should be used here only. It should not be used in these cells. So you can, this is called as formula auditing. So verify whether you have written the correct formula or not. We can remove the arrow. Let's say we write this formula, which I have put it in the chat. Okay. So if I write this formula, whether this will work or not. Okay. So I think some mistake is there. So actually it should be, okay. $C$2. I think he meant $C$6. Right. I think so. Okay, so I think so. So if I put this one, what will happen? Okay. Let's see, go to the trace precedence and see that this cell is using correctly. It is using correctly this 8%, but it is wrongly taking this as the income. Now, why? Why? Because the formula that you have was $C$6. You have fixed this income. So when you are going down, row will not change. It will remain as 6. When you are going right, column will not change, which is correct. But row changing, not changing is a problem. So it should not be $C$6. It should be $C6 × D$2. That should be the correct formula. And you can just see trace precedence. Go trace precedence. That you can check, okay, it should be coming correctly. So that is a way you can audit your formulas. Okay, so what type of formula is this? What type of referencing is $C6? $C means column fixing. 6 means row is not fixed. Okay, right. What about D$2? Column is not fixed, but row is fixed. So both of them are mixed referencing formulas. Okay. Anybody, any doubt? You want me to repeat any of the things that we have covered just now? Okay. So now you may be thinking that how do we decide before writing the formula, whether which one to fix? So see, we can do this by using trial and error by dragging. Okay? But we have to start thinking when we are writing the formula. So I am writing the formula here. I have to multiply this and this. Okay. So to start thinking, when I am dragging it down, this guy should not change. But when I am dragging this to the right, this has to change. So column has to change. So column has to change. So column, there should be no fixing. But the row should not change. So row should not change. So row should be fixed. Column should change. So D will become E. E will become F. So this, there will be no fixing. Right? So that we have got the tax rate. What about the income? When we are dragging down, the income should change. So 6 will become 7. 7 will become 8. So we will write 6. So there will be no anchoring before it. But when we are moving to the right, I should not refer to D6. I should still refer to the same column C. So when we are moving to the right, the column should not change. So what we should do? We should write C and we should put dollar before it. That means when we are dragging, column is not changing. So column has to be fixed. Row, no fixing. Right? So before writing the formula, if you think slightly like this, you will write a better formula. So and think what is changing and then write the formula. Okay. Okay. Yeah. A very good question. We have how to enter dollar instead of manually typing the dollar. F4 to enter the dollar is not working. Yeah. Please note that some of your laptops have F2, F3 button can be only pressed by using along with the function key, as Jatin has replied. So you use function and then F4. So use function and then F4. It will work. Okay. You can actually change the setting also when you are working with Excel. So only pressing the F4 button should work. Just search on Google how to do it. But as of now, you can press function and F4. Okay. So starting, you should think about which one to fix. Let's see this another problem that we have. Okay. So these are the marks for the student A, B, C, and they have got marks in mathematics and physics. So let's see physics. Okay. So these students have got actually very low marks. Okay. So they went to the HOD and they said that we want higher marks. Okay. So HOD said that, okay, increase the marks of all these students by 5. So you have given a grace marks to all these students 5 marks, and let's say you want to compute the new marks for these students, and you have to write a formula here such that this grace marks will get added, and one formula will come here and it should be dragged to the right, to the down. Only one formula you have to write. How will you write the formula? What formula to be written? As of now, I know that, okay, 40 plus 5 to be done. This is like one simple structure we have, but we have to now think here how to write the formula smartly. So what to be done? Okay. So you see here, when you are dragging to the right, will this grace marks change? No, because there is no grace marks here. Grace marks is only 1 marks. So you have to fix what? So dragging, it is not changing. So dollar C you have to make. C should not change. Column should not change. Now when you are dragging down, so what will happen? When you drag down, it will become C3, C4. But we don't want C2 to change. 2 should not change. So your row should not change. So what you should do is you should fix the row also. So dragging right, dragging down, this is not changing. So this is your absolute fixing. Both column and row are fixed. So we will write this in our formula. Next, what? What about the marks, subject marks, old marks? When you are shifting to the right, so earlier you had the maths marks, you should have the physics marks now. So when you are shifting to the right, Here you should refer to the old physics marks. So what should happen? So will your column should change? Yes, column should change. Here I should refer to B7. I should not refer to C7. So your column has to change. So there will be no fixing in the column. Okay. Now when you're going down in the maths, so your 40 should become 45 for the student B. So your row is changing. So C7 will become C8. It will become C9. So is your row changing? Yes, row should change. So should you fix row? No, we should not fix row. Right? So that means this will remain as C7. So no fixing of the row, no fixing of the column. So let's see, we drag it to the down and we drag it to the right and we go to the formula and we say trace precedence. So see, we are getting correctly 40 and 5 we are adding. Okay, we are going here. We are seeing 50 and 5 we are adding. Okay. So you have to decide on the structure of the formula beforehand only in the first cell. Don't worry about the other cells. If you can decide it properly here, okay, your work is done. So just identify whether the column will change, whether the row will change. If it is changing, don't fix it. If it is not changing, fix it. That's the idea. Okay. Anybody, any doubt? Okay. Yeah. Good, Sabri. Okay. Let's see. This is another problem structure I have. Okay. So here, these are the workers we have. Your students in US, they get some hourly salary. Okay. So you have students. So these students are, working in VCU under different professors. And there, you get some hourly salary because you are doing some work for the professor. Right? So you have A, B, C, three students are there. Okay, so the student A has worked 5 hours. Okay, and we want to understand the situation. What if he had worked 10 hours, how much he would have got? If he would have worked 15 hours, how much he would have got? If he would have worked 20 hours, how much he would have got? Right? So we want to create a formula on this first part. Let's say we hide this. Okay. So how we can create a formula? So we have to see when we are writing the hours work, this is 5, the hourly salary is this 10. This is a simple formula. Now you have to think when you are moving to the right, the hourly salary column should change. So column should change. So C should remain as C. But when you are dragging down, will this change? No, it will not change. So 4 has to remain fixed. Okay, so you will put $4. What about this B5? When you are moving, B should not change. So you put B. It is a similar problem that we saw that time. $B5. And when we are moving down, B5 should change to 6, 6 to change to 7. So this is our formula. And we drag it. So we can see trace precedence and we got it correctly. Trace precedence 10, 15. We got it correctly. But the problem was not that this. I made it simple. Okay, the problem is this. Let's say the professor has decided to give 10% bonus. Okay. So there is a bonus of 10% they will get. And if they have worked for 10 hours, how much they will get? If they work for 15 hours, how much they will get? If they work for 20, how much they will get? So we have to write a formula. So normally how much they will get? 5 into 10, 50. But there's a 10% bonus. So 50 plus 10% of 50 they will get. Okay. So many students write formula like this. It's okay. But since 50 is common, I would suggest that you write a formula like this. 50 into 1 plus 10%. Okay. This looks better. Okay. But even though grammatically, theoretically, practically, this is also correct. Okay, no problem. So that means we have to multiply. How we got 50? 50 we got by B5 and C4. So what will be our formula now? It will be B5 into C4 into 1 plus 10%. Okay, this is what we have got the formula. Now we have to write a smart formula. But before that, I will say one typical error I have seen in students making, because we are used to working with pen and paper. So this formula people write, okay, without doing the explicit multiplication here, because the bracket we think it will multiply. When we press error, it is giving ref. This ref is a reference error, because Excel is trying to find out this as one cell, C4 bracket 1. It is saying that there is nothing like that. It is not able to find that cell. So it will give a ref error. So always ensure that before bracket, if you have a multiplication, you put the star sign properly. Okay. Okay. Now, how do I write a formula here? So I have entered a bare bone thing. Now you have to think. Probably you can put it in the chat. You think and you put it in the chat. So first think about this B5. Whether this B5 should change, what should happen to B5. Actually, we did that just now. Okay. So what to be done? Okay, so B5, we know that column B should not change. So we should have $B, but the row should change. So 5, 6, 7, it can become. Regarding C4, we saw that it should become DE. So C should not change. But when we are dragging down, we should refer to this 4 only, cell number, row number 4. So we should fix 4 here. Now, what about this? It is similar to that students getting grace marks. When you are going down, you don't want this to change down. So you should fix the row 1. When you are going to the right side, again the 10% bonus is fixed for everybody, right? So the column should also not change. So what we do is, so we fix first the row. Going down, it is not changing. And column also it is not changing. So this becomes your formula. Okay, you can do the press precedence and you can see, yes, 15 hours, 10% bonus, 20. So please note that press precedence will only check for the referencing correctly. It doesn't say that whether your formula is correct, because instead of, let's say, writing 1 plus, suppose somebody writes 1 minus, okay, for whatever the reason. Okay, trust precedence will show you, okay, this and this, it is showing correctly, but the answer is wrong because of minus sign. So trust precedence only checks for the referencing part, not the formula part. Okay, so this is what we call as the creation of the smart formula. You, even if the cells are like 10,000, 20,000, you write formula once and you can, that is where the power of Excel will be utilized. Okay. Okay. So let's see, I will, instead of write talking like this, let's say, suppose we create, let's say, suppose Sachin's matches are being written here. So Sachin has, let's say, scored just some random number, 10 in first match of a series, let's say 25, then he scored 105, then let's say 95, then let's say 150. Okay. We want to know, okay, for the purpose of calculation of the man of the match of the series, okay, we want to know how much the score cumulative has been scored. what is the cumulative run scored by the player or Sachin here. So we have to write a formula here. So how we can write a formula here such that we can get a cumulative score. Okay. Now that there are multiple ways to write the formula. Okay. One of the way I see students writing is like this. So they will say first cell, they will refer to the first one. And the next cell, what they will do is they will refer to this. So what is the cumulative? So the next match, the cumulative will be 25 scored in the next match plus the previous cumulative. Plus the previous cumulative. So they will refer, they will do plus and previous cumulative, 35. And then they will drag it down. Okay, see this, how it works. So the cumulative score is 10 in the first match, second match it is 25 plus 10, 35. Third match cumulative score is 105 plus the 35, which is 140. Now the issue with this formula is that you have to still write two formula. You have written one formula here and one formula for this entire range. Okay. By the way, actually when I'm saying dragging, you can do also one of the thing. You can go here and double click. When you do the double click, it will automatically guess where is the ending and it will fill the formula till that. See, it is not filling the formula here because there are no values for these two rows. Right? Now the question is that should this be accepted? Is this a smart formula? You have written a formula here. You have written a formula for this. Two formulas are written. Okay? So one way the students do is this. They write this plus this one. Okay. They think that, okay, this is a text cell. Okay. So see, this is a text cell. You do a plus. So without this, it will work. But the moment you write something over here, okay, it gives you a error, value error. Right. So you cannot work that way. Right. Then people will say, okay, sir, I can do this probably. Sum this comma this. See. The plus does not work. Plus shows the error when it's a non-number. But sum, sum is a function in Excel. So sum is substitution of plus. It will add all the values which you get. So it is summing D4 comma F3. And then they will say, okay, I will drag this down. Okay. And this will work because you have written one formula. But I don't recommend you this. Because here it's a cell, see some values. What if some number comes? Okay. So this is not recommended. Even though you get it correctly, I don't recommend writing formula like this. Okay. So how we can write a formula which can be smart? Okay, we write it once and it cover all other cells. What to be done? Okay. So we will bring a concept of range. So in Excel, okay, actually everything is a range. So when we talk about, let's say C1 as a cell, okay, this is called a cell range. Okay, right? You can actually select, let's say from here to here. So see, it is starting point is E12. This is E12. Okay. And what is the ending point? F15. Okay. So how the Excel will write this? Excel will write this using colon. So Excel write like this. E12 colon F15. So this colon is a symbol for the range. Even though I say E12 is a range, but the correct range is colon. So whenever you see E12 colon F15, you understand, okay, the first cell is E12 and the last cell is E15. So how you can get from E12 to E15? Only when you have covered this entire area. Okay. Right. Now if I say E12 to E18, if I write E12 to E18, what will it be? So E12 will start and we are ending with E18. So your range will be, this will be your range. Okay. So you can have a range only in the column. You can have a range, let's say as an example, I can have a range only in the row. I can have an example of range only in the row. This is an example of a range. It is starting at E12 and ending at H12. So this is a one range. You can have only column, only row, or you can have both row and column. Right? The representation is same with the colon. Okay. So what we do is we think of this as a range. Okay. So this is a range we are talking about, E4 to E8. Okay. Can you write a function? Can you write a formula using sum such that when you drag this formula down, it will compute the cumulative score of this. It will compute the cumulative score. This is very, very smart work that you can write. You have to write one formula. Right? So what I do is, see this, what I'm writing currently. Okay. See this, I have written D4 colon D4. So D4 colon D4, even though I have given colon sign, but still it is showing only one range. Because how come it will say D4 colon D4 will be two different things. Right? It is same. Okay. So let me write sum D4 colon D4, enter. Okay. I will write here one formula, sum D4 colon D5. Okay. I will write here one formula, sum D4 colon D6. Okay. Now you think about it, what we are doing. Okay. And you have to answer me, how can a smart formula? I have created a formula in every cell now. Okay. So if I see the formula over here, okay. See this, the formula which we have written, focus on this formula. We have written D4 colon D4, D4 colon D5, D4 colon D6, 7, 8. Okay. Right. I have entered in every cell. How can I convert this to a smarter formula such that the formula will be written here and dragged to the end? You have to think what is changing and what is not changing. Can anybody send me privately the formula which you probably you want to write here and drag it down and it will change? It will do the valuation completely, the calculation. Okay. So focus on this part. Focus on this part. When you drag, the row should change 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It is happening. So should you make it relative? Yes, let make it relative 4, 5, 6. Okay, let it D remain. But focus on this part. Now the blue highlighted one. What is happening here? Is this guy changing? 4 is remaining constant, 4. So what to be done? If 4 is remaining constant as 4, what can we do? Right. So we can make it fix, right? Very good. Yeah, I got lot of response. Very good, guys. Very good. So what we can do is we can fix this D$4 and let it remain D4 and drag it down. Right? So that means you have created one formula in one cell and it is working. Okay. And dragging in all the cell, it is working fine. And it is not worried about whether you have a number here or not. Okay. So this is the correct approach to create anything which is accumulated, cumulative. Okay. An example could be those who are coming from BCom, BBA, you can see accumulated depreciation is an example. Okay. You can create a formula like this. Okay. Or if you are creating a frequency table, you can create cumulative frequency using this type of formula. Okay. So this is another one. Okay. The last part that we have is, okay, so we discuss about sum as one function, okay, even though this class is not about the function, okay, but we can have some situation, okay, wherein you have to do calculation involving two different columns. Okay. Suppose as an example, the same, let's say hours worked. There is this, okay. Okay, let's see. There is a student. Okay, A, B, C student. D, four students are there. Okay, and they have worked hours work. They have done 10 hours work, 20 hours. They have done 15. They have done 5 hours. Okay, and each of them have some hourly rate. Okay, so let's say this guy is getting, let's say, $12 an hour, and he's getting $15 an hour. He's getting 10 an hour, and he's getting 12 an hour. Okay, right. So this is my data. Okay, let's say you are the professor who has hired all these students. Okay, you want to know how much is the weekly payment that you are going to give to them. Okay, so normally what we know is, okay, what is his billing? So 10 into 12, it will be 120. 20 into 15, 300. 15 into 10, 150. And 5 into 12, 60. So you are doing the product of each of these. And then to compute your billing, you have to find the sum of this. Right? So let's put what you are doing is you are finding out the sum. But the sum you are not finding individually. You are finding the sum of the sum product. So you are computing the product of hours worked and hourly rate, and you are summing them up. That is what you are doing. So in Excel, you have a beautiful function, which is sum product. You can use that. So what the sum product does is, it will, so let's see, first we see the syntax of this sum product. So syntax of this sum product is, if you see, it is taking array 1, array 2, array 3. Array is nothing but the range, which we talked about. Okay. So you are saying that I want to multiply one range with the other individual items and take the sum of it. That is what the sum product does. It will multiply the individual items and sum it up. Okay. So in this case, my first array will be F, okay, whatever the row, and this will be my, so let's say F 5 to F8 will be my first array. My second array will be G5 to G8. Okay. Oh, sorry. G5 to G8. Some issue with the mouse. Okay. Yeah. So F5 to F8, G5 to G8. Okay. And we want the answer to come. And we see the answer and see what is this. So what we'll do is we are already computing this all, and we are summing this. See, we have got 630 here. We have got 630 here. See, we have done so much work to get the answer. A sum product, very easily get it. Okay, but you have to think what it is doing. So this is doing this multiplied by this, this multiplied by this, this multiplied by this, this multiplied by this, and summing it up. So that is what the sum product do. Right? Even though this is only one function I will cover, this class is more on the referencing, but this referencing, you can see that in one cell you can get, even if it is like thousands of rows, you can get it in one shot. Okay. Okay. So let's see. So the concept class is over. If you have any doubt, you can ask. So we have to understand the referencing here, and I introduce one sum product. Okay, sum you know. Okay. Please note that in Excel, average is also a function. Okay. So sometimes you can take the average. Okay. But some of the places, okay, this average calculation is a simple average. Okay. So as an example, if I ask a question to you, okay, how much is the hourly, average hourly rate the professor is paying? Average hourly rate by professor. What will be the answer? Anybody? What is the average hourly rate this professor is paying? So he's paying 12 to one student, 15 to another, 10 to another, 12 to another. What is the average hourly rate paid by the professor? Can anybody give me this answer? So if I write like this, average, 12.25. Will it work? Okay, so some of you have answered. Very good. Okay, will this 12.25 work average of this hourly rate? Okay, please note that this average will not work. In fact, I am taking this. I have covered this for like some of the students who are in MBA also. Okay, you are undergrad, you are better. Okay, because there they will take this as the average and say 12.25 is the average. Okay, no, it is not correct. Because this hourly rate, the 12.25 will work only when the number of hours work is same. Suppose let's say all of them have worked 10 hours. Okay. Right? Then this 12.25 is not a problem. Okay. Why? Because this, when it is varying, you cannot take as a simple average. Okay. Right? So let's see, I will compute this first average hourly rate by simple average. What we are doing is, you have to compute how much is the total payment by the professor. And you have to find out how much is the total hours worked by the student. So what is the total hours worked by the student? 40. How much is his payment? 490. So your average hourly payment will be 12.25. 490 by 40, 12.25. It is coming exactly like your average calculation. But the moment this guy has worked for 15 hours, see this. Here it is 12.22, but your average function is giving 12.25. And see this, it is lower than 12.25 because this his rate was lower than the average. Right? So when he worked more, the average will go down. Right? So average formula in Excel, right? Average formula in Excel will not work. In case of problems like this. So what you have to do? So what you have to do is you have to do the sum product. You have to compute the total hours, total payment. Sorry, some issue is there in the mouse. Okay. So total payment divided by the total hours worked. You can actually write this in one single shot, 12.22. Right. So don't use average unnecessarily. Average will work only in case of simple arithmetic average. Okay. Okay. Now let's see the assignments that we have created for this week. I'll just quickly walk through that assignment. Okay. So you have actually 10 sheets are there in this assignment. Okay. Most of the problems are simple. The way which we have discussed, it will be similar to that. So you have question number one. So some hours worked, hourly rate, payment. Okay. So you have to compute all these things. And we are giving you the correct answer. So that when you are writing a formula, you can compare with the correct answer. So please note that, however, correct answer doesn't mean that your answer formula will be correct also. Right? So you write a smart formula. Okay. So this is which we discussed just now. And this is your tax rate will be there. Employee salary is there. You have to compute what is the tax deduction and how much is the after tax salary. And you have to find out total before tax salary, tax deduction and after tax salary. Idea is that you think of formula such that it can be dragged to the all the other cells. Question number three is you have to create a multiplication table, which you actually, we did it in our like kindergarten. Okay. So you have to create a formula such that you should create a table. And I have given the hint, use a formula, write a formula and drag to other cells. Now this is a compounding formula. You are depositing some money with some interest rate. You want to know how much the money will become at the end of 1 year, 5 year, 10 year, 40 years. You have to create a table. Like again, you have to write one formula, drag it to the all the cells. Question number five, okay, like it looks intimidating. Okay, it looks like difficult. It is not difficult. Okay. This is like you are working, let's say, suppose as accountant to some one of the shop. You want to know how much is the sales and the gross profit in the future months. So some data is given, first month sales is given, growth in the sales is given, price per unit is given, growth in price is given, raw material cost is given, growth in raw material cost is given. Right? You have to write a formula. Okay, please note that in this case, you have to write one formula here. You have to refer to this cell 3000, and then this will keep on growing. So you have to create another set of formula here, such that you have to write one formula and drag it to all the other cells. Because the growth is on month basis. The growth is not on the initial values. So many students, they write a formula. They'll say that August sale will be 3000 into 1 plus 2%. September will be 3000 into 1 plus 2%. No, the growth will be month on month. Think about it. Similar will be for the price, total revenue. And I have given already the formula here. What is total revenue? In case somebody is not knowing this, you can just see the formula that is there. Then raw material cost per unit for the month or other months, total raw material cost, unit sold into cost per unit, and the gross profit, total revenue minus. So answer is also given. So you have to write a formula such that it can be dragged. Question number 6, we talked about the cumulative. You have to write a formula such that cumulative comes properly. Okay. Question number 7, salesman commissions are given for different, so sales amount is given by the different salesmen, their commission rate is given. You have to write a formula, one formula, drag it such that all the salesmen commissions are computed. Question number 8 is again similar. Sales growth is given. You have to compute the GST. GST rate is given. And you have to find out the total invoice amount. Question number 9 has some subpart. 3 questions are there. These are simple business maths problem. So some survey was taken. You have to find out the percentage of the vote against the motion. Then mileage of the cars are given. Average mileage is required. Again, this is where I have only found probably 1% of the students in my class is able to correctly answer this. I am giving average will not work here. Okay, you have to think how to write a formula correctly. Then this is regarding a courier package. So the weight of the courier is given, the charges are given per kg, but there is a fixed cost for shipping. You have to find out the total cost. Then this is a problem related to insurance premium calculation. Let's say you have a multiplex chain. You have to find out, you have the different number of seats of this multiplex, to find out how much the total insurance premium and how much is the premium allocated to each of your shop. Each of your multiplex and the total seats. And then there's cinema hall you have created. There's an increase in insurance also. You have to find out the total seats and the total premium that you are allocated. Right? So the marks is given for each of this. At the starting also you can see what is the marks. Okay, so it is out of 100. All questions are compulsory. There is no optional. And you cannot change this sheet. So it will come up with your user ID in the grading assistance. So please don't mess with this sheet, detail sheet. You can only work on these sheets. Okay. Do not add any sheet. Okay. Do not shift the sheets. Okay. In fact, I will fix those, but do not move the sheets unnecessarily, because then it will impact your marks. Okay. Is there any doubt you have? Okay. Now, yeah, where you can download the videos after. So all these webinar videos are getting recorded. Okay. So after the class, actually, you can go to our website, this knowledgevarsity.com. So go to knowledgevarsity.com. Okay. Go to ongoing programs. Okay. I will send the link directly. And in this, you will have Christ VCU joint certification. Click on this. So for the unit 1, the webinar recording, this is the entire syllabus we have. For every unit, you will have the webinar link and the webinar recording. You can click on this watch webinar recording. It will bring to a Google Drive folder. As of now, there is no file. At the end of this webinar, I will create a folder unit 1. In that folder, I will keep the webinar video. I will keep this Excel file, which we discussed in the class. Assignment link you will get by 6 o'clock you will get your assignment link by email. So by email you will get, and you can download the file, work on the file and upload in the assignment link. Okay, yeah, please note that there are some recent students have joined. You will get your user ID, okay, by 6 o'clock along with the assignment link. So if anyone has not got user ID, and WhatsApp group, actually I did add some of you, okay, but I have not been able to add everyone. So what I have done is I have sent you one message. Okay, we will invitation to join this WhatsApp group. So I'm just putting to everyone here. Those who are not there in the WhatsApp group, this is the group link. You can click and add yourself to the group. Okay. So by 6 o'clock, if you do not get any email, please either respond on this WhatsApp group, or you can email to us. The email is support@gradingassistance.com. Okay. And yesterday, probably if you have not come, okay, you can watch the VCU webinar recording, okay, here. So in the introductory session, recording is available. Okay. And along with the recording, you also have this presentation. So which we gave this presentation. So this presentation had some links like syllabus link, course web page, WhatsApp group invitation, and support email. And this is my email, instructor email. If you have any course content thing related query, you can ask here. But if you have anything related to assignment submission, files not working, I would request you to send a message to grading assistance team. They will handle. Okay, I would say that you on a regular basis, you just keep track of this page. So on a regular basis, I would say you just keep track of this page. Here only you will get the webinar. Here only you will get your assignment link. But the question file link and the graded file link will come to you by email. And the email you will get from me, ratan@knowledgeversity.com. Okay. And any query you have, please feel free to ask. Okay, guys. So thanks. It was a wonderful class I had. A good interaction. I hope that we'll continue this for the next 7 weeks or 7 classes. And again, I will say, work on the files yourself. If you have any query, we also have forum. You will get invitation for forum also. We have WhatsApp group. Please work yourself. Don't copy paste the formula, because learning will not happen if you do that. Okay. So thanks a lot. And let's meet the next. We are meeting Friday for the marks clarification and grading process. And so a class will be on Saturday and Friday. So Saturday is a concept class, and Friday you will have the marks clarification class. Okay. Thank you. Thanks for joining. Thanks for your valuable time.